So I needed a new desk, and since I spend a lot of time at my desk, I wanted a nice one. After searching Amazon.com, the ErGear electric standing desk was chosen, model number EGES-D6B-4. That sounds technical, doesn't it? Well, the short version of this review is that it's the best desk I've ever owned. However, it didn't start out that way, as I was a bit concerned when the box was delivered. Two people needed to carry it. But the box wasn't as wide as I expected. This was supposed to be a 55-inch desk. Where's the rest of it? Also, do I need a degree in engineering to put this thing together? After opening the box, I felt a bit overwhelmed. But surprisingly, even though this is a big electric desk, I was able to put it together all by myself. It was pretty easy overall, but the task probably would have been easier with two people. The instructions were great, and the parts were labeled nicely. Two of the three needed tools were included. I only needed a screwdriver, although I did have some pieces left over after assembly. I kinda screwed up. Two of the metal plates were not attached in the center. Also, with the keyboard tray, I used the wrong screws. So, it's important to read the instructions carefully. But, despite those mistakes, the desk feels fairly sturdy. The main part of the design is that the top of the desk is split in the middle. That's how such a large surface area was delivered in a narrow box. A significant part of the assembly is putting the two halves together, and then securing it to the metal legs. That was when I started liking the desk. I could feel the work that went into its creation. It's the little things that made me happy, like a bag of spare parts. That's nice. Now, if this was just a normal desk with a sliding keyboard tray, it wouldn't be special. What makes this desk significant is motorization. With just a push of a button, the desk can rise dramatically in height. I'm not kidding about that part. When I first tried the height adjustment, I was wondering how high it was going to go. It was more than I expected. It was also quite welcome. Since I'm over 6 feet tall, things in the world feel about a foot too short. With the power of this desk, I can finally feel comfortable. Previously, I was using blocks of wood to raise my desk. That didn't feel very safe, and that setup made the desk more difficult to move around. But with the ErGear desk, wow, it was just so nice. I even wrote this part of the script while standing. It was wonderful. I could stand up like a human. It kind of reminds me of an arcade, where standing upright is the norm. But, with a press of a button, the desk can switch from a standing desk to a sitting desk. Even while sitting, it was great to finally have my monitor at eye level. That's what the name ErGear is about. I wrote to the company and asked how to pronounce the name. Here's a direct quote. The ER part comes from the first two letters of ergonomic, and their website backs that up. It says the market lacked quality, yet affordable, ergonomic product lines. I think that sums up this desk perfectly, as it feels like a quality desk, but it wasn't very expensive. It was only $240. I was considering gaming desks that were substantially more expensive. So this desk is a nice middle ground. There is a bit of shake if I push on it, but even at 46.5 inches off the ground, it seems sturdy. The display shows a range from 72 to 118. So it seems that the numbers are metric. The value is in centimeters. I like to have the desk at 88 for sitting. Not only do I find this height to be more comfortable, it reminds me of Back to the Future. The display isn't always on. The lights turn off soon after inactivity. You might want to be careful with the height though. I had to make sure that the cables were long enough in order to match the maximum height of the desk. I like this desk, but there are some things that I don't like. The wrist rest seemed way too stiff. No problem, I just didn't attach it. I'm using my own wrist rest. The keyboard tray is a little cramped, but it has just enough space to fit my keyboard and mouse. The keyboard tray stopper really maximizes the space, as I don't have to worry about my keyboard falling backwards. It just stays put. Overall, this desk is impressive, but I'm just one guy. What do other people think? So I looked at the negative reviews on Amazon.com. Some were really brutal. One said, "It smells like cigarettes." Well, that does sound unfortunate. However, that wasn't my experience. While I did clean the desk after assembling it, the desk didn't smell like much of anything to me. Another reviewer said, "Really poor packaging." But that wasn't my experience either. I was surprised at how well it was packaged. One of the corners was slightly damaged, but I suppose I could just color that in with a marker. I don't think that was related to the packaging either, as there were protective corner guards. Another one-star review stated that the keyboard tray is not stable. I don't know if I agree with that. The keyboard tray feels pretty good to me. I do consider it delicate, though. If I had to guess which part of this desk would break first, I suspect it would be the keyboard tray. I don't know of the long-term durability of this desk, but it seems okay so far. The motor seems tough, but I'm probably not going to use it that much. I've even been resisting the urge to treat the desk like a toy, as the sound that it makes is just so cool. It sounds like a sci-fi movie. Anyway, that's the video. Hopefully this information helps you out. Thanks for watching.